See over there? That's your cafe.
So it is.
5 blocks away.
I can't even like speak when I see this scene in a way, because that particular apartment and that particular setting, looking over the Seine, which it did, it looked over the water, and Tony in his scarf and beret and being truly in Paris, like that's not a soundstage. I swear I thought, okay, it's done. Like this is heaven, and it doesn't get more grand. And it was so amazing, and that this character had like a rebirth, because I felt like I got to have rebirth too. You know, I'm in my 50s, mm-hmm. you know, I'm definitely at a point in my life where you sometimes go, what next? And I just thought, well, we can all be reborn. We just have to travel to Paris and have some croissants.
I love, love, love this show, and I'm clearly not alone. When you signed on for The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, did you know that it would be so beloved, so well received?
From the second I read the pilot, it felt like it was so brilliant and so funny.
Yes.
And Rachel Brosnahan, when I met her, is such a special, unique human. And mm-hmm. I thought, I hope the world responds the way I'm responding, but I actually never know. So I didn't have an idea at all. And oh, this is funny. We were invited to the Golden Globes that year and we were sitting really far back. So I don't think anyone thought we would win. And I remember they called our show's name. We actually won. And you could tell everybody turned around like, wait, who are they?
Ooh,
like, what is that show? You know? So we, at the point that we were even starting to garner some real attention that way, I don't even think the audience had caught on yet.